हेलो, गुड आफ्टरनून स्टूडेंट्स।
डॉक्टर सर, गुड आफ्टरनून।
सो लेट अस वेट फॉर अ फ्यू मिनट्स एज स्टूडेंट्स आर स्टिल इन अ प्रोसेस ऑफ जॉइनिंग। ओके, सो We need to understand about the operating I hope and the screen is visible. Students, I hope this screen is visible.
Yes, sir.
So today we are only going to have a few numericals based on diode and diode circuits. Right? So first of all, let me start with the equivalent circuit. Okay, so you know that the symbol of diode is like this, right? So this is positive terminal, this is negative terminal. Now, if we look at...
Sir, can you speak a little louder?
Yeah, actually there is an issue with mic also, fine, I'm speaking louder only, but there is an issue, fine, so please bear with me today, okay?
Okay, sir.
We know that this real diode contains the barrier potential, right? So barrier potential voltage is recognized in V0, and this V0 is 0.7 for Si and 0.3 is for germanium, fine. So V0 is the potential barrier voltage, fine, and having a forward bias resistance. So when we draw the diagram circuit, then there would be forward voltage as well as there is a resistance of the diode, fine, and this resistance is known as RF, forward resistance. Sometimes it is written as RF, fine, and this voltage is V0 here, fine. So the total voltage across the diode is VF. So we can write VF is the forward voltage across the diode, that is equal to IFRF, because if the current is IFRF, right? So IF is the current, so IFRF is the total voltage VF into RF. If it is capital, we can write IF into RF plus V0, right? So V0 is the potential barrier, and based on this diode, it is 0.7 and 0.3. So we can write the voltage drop or total forward voltage across the diode, that can be written as IFRF into VO, fine. So this is very simple. So here we already discussed 0.3 is for germanium and 0.7 is for silicon, fine. So let's have based on this, we have one example. Suppose if we have a battery and there is a resistor and two diodes are connected, and another battery is connected like this, suppose 20 volt, here it is 4 volt. We can see this is diode D1, diode D2, and this resistor is around 2.2 kilo. Okay, now the question is calculate the current flowing through 2.2 ohm resistor. So we need to find out the current flowing through this. From this. Now here in this example one diode is connected in forward bias and another is connected in reverse bias. So here first of all we are going to find out where D1 is forward bias. And D2 is reverse bias. Here in this case, we can draw the equivalent circuit. So we know that the current will flow from this only, right? From this diode, and this will become open circuit. So here we can have draw this diagram. Like this is a short circuit because this diode is going to be conducted and this would be like a open circuit. So this is our circuit where we are going to solve and we will find the current flowing through it. Okay. Now what would be the current I if we apply the law? I would be 20 minus 4 volt, so 24 volt, fine, because this is minus plus, this is plus minus, so we can have this divided by 2.2 kilo ohm, or we can say into 10 raised to 3 because it is, and the answer becomes 16 by 2.2, so something 7. Something answer is there, 7.27 into 10 raised to minus 3 ampere. Fine, so this is the current. Okay. Now, this way you can find out because in the circuit, different types of diodes are given, either connected in forward or reverse bias, and according to that, you have to short the circuits. Because here diodes are considered as ideal diodes. Right? So we may not consider equation of IF is equal to IFRF, VF is equal to IFRF plus V0. Because here potential barrier, forward resistance, everything is not given in this circuit. And hence, directly we can find that there is a potential difference, so this plus this plus this is equal to zero, so ultimately we can get this kind of equation. So 20 plus this or something like that minus this, so we can find the current flowing through this. Okay, now let us have one more example based on half wave rectifier. Okay. Now, for half wave rectifier, we know that one diode is connected, the transformer is there, like this, and there is a load connected, like this. This is a load, this is a diode D1, and this is transformer, maybe step up or step down. Now we have a discussion about various terminology during RMS value. We have derived few equations during RMS value, that is IDC. We had a relation between IDC and IVC current. So IDC is the amount of current flowing through this diode. Fine. And that can be written with AM by pi. Where IM is the AC current, alternating current. Fine. So this relationship that can be that we can use for calculation purpose for half wave circuit. And second equation we derived for IRMS that is equal to IN by 2. Fine. So this is for half wave rectified, and for full wave rectified also we have derived in the previous example called AC fundamentals. Fine. So we are going to use the similar kind of stocks here for calculation purpose. Okay. Now, what is output voltage VDC? Fine. So suppose now we are considering. Power is there, diode is connected, right? And if there is unknown, so we can consider it as the resistance of this is RL, the current flowing that is IL, this is diode D. Now, here we can consider it as input voltage VI, fine, and here. They can get the output voltage VO. So VO is the output voltage. VI is the input voltage. RL is the load resistance. And VDC. So VO sometimes it is written as VDC also, because here after rectification we get V. So VC or VD sometimes it is written as VDC. Fine. So this output voltage is in DC, VDC. This input voltage is AC. Fine. So that could be taken care of. Okay. Now if I want to write an expression of VDC, so this is VDC. So VDC can be written as IL into R. So IL is what? DC current, because the current flowing from this is DC. So IL is DC. Fine. So here we can write VDC into RL. This way. So current into this is the total output voltage here, and that can be written as, now IDC can be written as IN by pi, where IN is the AC current. This is IN, AC current. Now after diode it is converted into DC. So this way we can write IN by pi into R. Okay, and we can write this expression in a different way. IM can be written as VM upon total resistance of the circuit. So RF is the resistance of this diode. RF is the resistance of the diode. Fine, so we can write RF plus another resistance is RL, and plus the resistance of secondary coil. This, because this is a transformer having an inductive circuit having a resistance also, so we can write another resistance RS also to RL. So VM, because whenever it is AC is considered, then this resistance plus resistance of diode plus resistance of this are connected in series. That is why it is written as like this. So if you want to find out the voltage VDC, that is VM on pi, RF plus RL plus RS. So RS is the secondary winding resistance, RL is the load resistance, and RF is the diode resistance. So we need to consider all this different, and then we can calculate the various parameters using this formula. And suppose if it is given the value of diode, load value and all the things, and then if they ask to find out the source voltage VM. So VM is the source voltage, input voltage, that you can calculate using this expression. Clear? Similarly, we can have another called full wave rectifier, and in full wave rectifier, only the thing which you need to be taken care of, that is IDC is equal to AM upon pi by 2. I am pi by 2. Once again, 2 times AM by pi. And similarly, I LMS is equal to AM by root 2, which we have calculated for full wave. Full wave rectifier, and we can have such kind of calculations. Now, in case of full wave rectifier, again we can have the same equation. VDC is equal to IDC into RL. Fine. Now IDC is, now here you can consider that IM by 2, right? Or you can say 2 IM upon pi into RL, and you can convert this current, because current is V by R, total resistance, right? So here you can write 2 into VM upon pi RF plus RL plus RS into RL. So this is an expression for VDC or full wave rectifier. What is the difference here? This is the difference. Okay. Now let's have a few examples based on this, and then we will check the version. Okay. First of all, we will have an example of half wave rectifier, and then we will have an example of full wave rectifier. Okay, I will write the question first. If AC supply of 230 volt is applied a half wave rectifier, circuit through a transformer of turn ratio 10:1, determine number 1 IM, IDC and IRMS, number 2 DC power output. Third is AC power input. And fourth one, that is efficiency of rectification. So tomorrow there is an examination. In examination, I might be asked for finding IM, IDC, IRMS, or DC power output, or AC input power, or efficiency. Right? So what will be the circuit here? The circuit is made up of a transformer having a ratio 10:1. That is what the ratio is given, 10:1. Right? and the input voltage is 230 volt, and there is a half wave rectifier circuit. So first of all, we are going to find out this, because input voltage V1 is given. What is the value of V2 here? So we can have V2 upon V1 is equal to N2 upon N1. So this is the ratio. Okay, so V2 can be calculated as N2 upon N1 to V1. So N2 is what? N2 is 1, N1 is 10 into V1, so V1 is 230 volt. So ultimately it is 23 volt. So here the voltage is 23 volt. Fine. Now this is 23 volt RMS, because 230 volt is always RMS, this is RMS. Now we can not into maximum value VM, that it is 3 times. Okay. So in this case, we can have root 2 into 23, and this is approximately 1.7. So 1.7 times of this is approximately 32.5 volt. Okay. So this way we can find the voltage VM, maximum voltage. These are RMS values. Okay. Now, our first case is to find out IM. Right. So IM can be calculated with the help of VM upon RF plus RL. Why we are considering these two? Because this is RF here, this is RL here. Right. So potential difference is already there. We are not calculating voltage drop here. Fine. So RS will not come into the picture. These two will come into the picture, because the current flowing through this, according to this 32.5 volt potential. So here we can calculate 32.5 upon RF is how much? 20. RF is not given, so you can consider right now RF is 20 ohm here and RL is 1 kilo ohm, right, in the circuit. So 20 ohm is the RF and 1 kilo ohm is your load resistance, right? So here we can write 20 ohm plus 1 kilo ohm means 1000. Okay, so 32.5 1020, how much it is? Approximately 31.89 milliampere. So this way you can calculate current IM. Okay. Now similarly we are going to calculate IDC. Now IDC is what? For half wave, it is IM by pi. Right? So 31.89 upon 3.14 is your answer. So 30 divided by 3 is approximately 10 point something, 10.15 milliampere. Right? So this is your IDC. Now, what is IRMS? This is equal to IM by 2 for half wave. So we can calculate 31.89. This is your IM by 2. So approximately it is 15.94. Okay. Now second is DC power output. Okay, so PDC, so I square R is your power loss, right? So here we can write IDC whole square into RI. Because this is what the amount of current flowing through after dam IDC will flow with this local distance RN. So the power will be consumed here IC into RN, right? So we can write this. Now the answer of IDC is 10.15 milliampere, so 10 is to minus 3 into ampere square into RL. So RL is how much? 1 kilo. 1 into 10 is 23 or 1000. Fine. So how much it is? EDC is, this is 10 just to the power 2. So ultimately 0.15. So approximately 103.02 into 10 is to minus 3 V1. Now the third is DC power input. DC power input is PAC. Fine. So pi RMS square into plus RF plus RM. Because this is the current input current, RMS current is there. So here there is a transformer. So your input voltage is 230 volt AC RMS. So whatever the amount of current flowing through into diode, that is your RMS current. And ERMS current mein jitna bhi resistance come into the picture. Fine. So this resistance will come into the picture, this resistance will come into the picture. Because the resistance is not given of this. So we can have only RF and RL. Clear? So we can calculate this as AC input power. So AC input power is IRMS that we calculated 15.94 into 10 raised to minus 3 whole square into 20 plus 1000. Clear? Please find it out. Please find out how much it is. How much it is? How much it is? Or we can say 259 millivolt. Fine. Like this. Is it okay? Is it okay? So whatever,
yes,
whatever the answer is, fine. You need to be correct in the examination only. So this is DC output power of when the diode is connected. This is AC input power. Fine. Now the fourth one is efficiency. Efficiency is what? Output upon input. So output power is DC. So we have this value 103.0 into 10 raised to minus 3. And what is input? Input is 259. Right? So 259 into 10 raised to minus 3. Right? So here we will get this efficiency. And efficiency is approximately almost double. Fine. The denominator is double, so approximately 40% or 39 point something 75%. So this is your efficiency, right? Okay. Now similarly we can find output voltage डीसी वोल्टेज, आउटपुट वोल्टेज वी डी सी, क्लियर वी डी सी, इट इज नॉट लास्ट ईयर टू फाइंड बट वी कैन फाइंड वी डी सी इज इक्वल टू आई डी सी इनटू आर एल. So the value of IDC is 10.15 ampere into RL is 10:2. Sorry, this is milliampere. Fine. So 1.. into 10:2 minus 3 because it is milliampere. Fine. And into RL is 1000. So this will be cancelled. So VDC is 10.15 volt. And VM is always considered as your PIV. PIV stands for peak inverse voltage. Sorry, my handwriting is not little. I would be too chicken. I could not write properly. Fine, so please bear. Peak inverse voltage. Fine, peak inverse voltage. Is it clear? So, whatever VM found, that sometimes they may ask that find out the peak inverse voltage. So that is same. So there are a number of examples given in the different books. Please go through it properly or find it. Okay. Now let's have another example of full wave rectifier. That's all an example.
The sixth coil is now equivalent. This coil, this one,
okay,
is getting
like. Let's all an example.
So this coil is getting like. So the opposite of this coil is one. Now what?
Rectifier circuit. Is faithful. A transformer.
So now in the opposite side of the coil comes here, there will be now the front side of the coil.
Center tap, secondary line. Here. Center tap, secondary line.
So every so
the RMS voltage for either side of the secondary to the center tap is 30 volt. So secondary voltage is given 30 volt. So the diode forward resistance RF that is given 2 ohm. That is half of the secondary. So here we can consider this RS is 8 ohm and RL is equal to 1.1. So these are the parameters given. So VRMS is given 30 volt on secondary side. So this four parameters are given, VDC, this, this and this. So only the thing which you need to be taken care of, that is VRMS is equal to VM by root 2. Fine. Like IRMS is equal to IM by root 2 for full wave. So this equation that you need to use. Right? So we want to find out VM. We are RMS into root 2. So how much it is? IRMS is 30 volt into root 2. So it's approximately 1.71 times. So 42.43. I have a calculator and I'm calculating by myself. Right? So this is VM. Similarly, if I want to find out current IM. So IM is VM upon RF plus RS plus RL, because here all these three resistors are given, right? And for that reason, I need to consider. So VM is how much? That is 42.43 upon ref is 2 ohm, sorry, 2 ohm plus 8 ohm plus 1 kilo ohm, so 1000 ohm. Okay, so I can calculate IM current here. So what is IM current now?
0.042.
Yeah, 0. So IM is 0.042, right? Okay. Now can we have IDC? IDC can be calculated as IM upon pi by 2. Or we can say 2 IM by pi. So 2 into 0.042 upon 3.84. How much it is? IDC.
You can say that
0.0267 MP. Right? Okay. So IDC calculated, IM calculated. Now what is the next? We can calculate IRMS also. So I RMS is equal to IM by 2. And IM is 0.042 by 2. So how much it is? Approximately 0.3. 0.29 MPa.
0.029.
0.029 MPa, right? So this way we can calculate IRMS also. Okay, now power delivered to the load means load side DC. So PDC is IDC square into RL. So what is IDC here? That is what we calculated here. IDC, right? IDC is 0.0267 whole square into RL. So the value of RL is 1000. Clear? So how much it is?
So if I want to
correct, 0.71289.
How much? 0.71288. Fine. Or you can convert into millivolt also. Millivolt. Fine. Now you can. Yes. Now we can calculate AC into power also. Yeah, please find it out. AC input power. TAC input power. So input may RMS value hoga, IRMS. IRMS whole square into total resistance. RF plus RL plus RS. Yeah. So we can have this 0.0297 as what we found. You find what is the value RF? RF is 2. Sorry, RF is 2, RS is 8, and RL is 1000. So we can find PDC 200. Please find it out.
Point 890
or 890 watt millivolt. Bravo. Fine. We can say it is 890 millivolt. Yeah. Now rectification efficiency. Is output PDC upon PAC. So PDC was approximately 715 upon 890. This is what you have input and multiplied by 100. So we can find the efficiency.
80.33.
33. So the efficiency is 80.33, right? Clear? So, dear students, this way, various numericals asked from half-wave and full-wave rectifier and even from diode circuits. So, all of you need to find out these examples from the various books, and all these examples are going to be asked in the examination also, right? So we have a syllabus of DC review, then AC circuits, AC series and parallel circuits, including AC fundamental and this diodes. So whatever I taught, right, regarding your diode, special purpose diodes, so the numericals, most probably they are going to ask from our chapter called AC series and parallel circuits. So 50% weightage is given to that chapter because that was the main chapter during our course conduction, fine. And from these 3-4 topics might be going to ask for 20%, then 30% is from DC review circuits, fine. So most probably you have to emphasizely put the weightage on numericals on AC circuits, AC series and parallel circuits, fine. The examples what today we covered, is that clear?
Yes, sir.
Yeah.
Yes, so, sir.
Students, this is what the syllabus we have in our sessional examination, which is going to be commenced on next day. I mean tomorrow. Fine. So wish you all the best for your examination, and be prepared. If you have any doubts, you can send me a mail also. I can immediately answer of it. Okay. So all the best. Thank you for.
Thank you, sir.
Fine. So the lecture is over now.
Thank you, sir.
You may leave now, please. Thank you. Yeah.